O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, you formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might no longer be two but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church. O God, by whom woman is joined to man and the companionship they had in the beginning is endowed with the one blessing not forfeited by original sin nor washed away in the flood, look now with favor upon these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant.
My little girl, Alex, is the only girl in my family. And that's my little girl, and she'll be my little girl forever. She can never do wrong. When we raised her to be independent, we raised her to be tough, and we raised her to be caring and loving, just like Trish and I are. And I see that in my daughter.
Thinking of our history, you can't start our history without the place that brought us together. At the moment I saw you, I couldn't help but thinking how organically beautiful you were. After getting to know you better, I couldn't help but think we had this connection.
Who knew I would fall so in love with the guy that threw balls at me on the playground and told all the kids that he was my boyfriend? Thank God you were so persistent. I thank God for putting you in my life when he did. You were just what I needed, even if I didn't know it yet.
Today, June 9th, 2018, is the day we become one and officially start a new chapter in our already amazing lives. You are my one true love, and I will spend the rest of my life caring and making sure that you know this.
Take you, Alex, to be my wife.
I, Alex, take you, Chris, to be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
To love you and to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Our time together is ended. Your life together just begun. Go in the love and the peace of Christ to serve and love the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
It's you and me now. Living the quiet life. It's you and me now. We've been burned once or twice. I say, ooh, come a little closer. I say, ooh.
Chris and Alex are a very special, special couple. You know, when I was walking my little girl down that aisle today, I saw the look in your eye. You love my daughter, and I saw that. And you know what? That gives me the greatest comfort in the world to know that you love my daughter. You're going to take care of her, and she's going to take care of you.
I say, ooh, come and make me
Chris and Alex, marriage is magical, but it definitely is not magic. Anytime you enter into a partnership, contract, relationship, long-term with anything as infallible as a human being, there are bound to be times of despair, great triumph, and when absolute messiness. And Alex, I want to let you know that you absolutely have somebody right here that'll glove up and jump in that tub with you. Congratulations.
Today, you and Chris have joined together as one, and this is just the beginning of a beautiful journey that you guys will both take together. If I could give you guys two words of advice, they would be compromise and communicate. And these are two things that can create a strong marriage and a happy life. And I'm so happy for you both. It's clear that you are both made for each other. We're happy to welcome you to the family, Chris. As long as you treat my cousin right and keep barbecuing, we're good.